हेलो गाइस, सो वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल वेयर वी आर गोइंग टू सी टुडे हाउ टू क्रिएट अ पीडीएफ फाइल। इन प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू हाउ टू क्रिएट अ पीएस फाइल, सो दिस इज द नेक्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ दैट वीडियो इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू सी हाउ टू क्रिएट अ पीडीएफ फाइल। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम वी शुड गो अहेड। सो टू क्रिएट अ पीडीएफ फाइल माय फर्स्ट स्टेप इज just follow the same step as we followed while creating the PS file. So go to utilities, type 3 in option. After that, press 2 in a data set to enter into the data set and just give the name of the PDF file that we are going to create. So before giving the name of it, I would like to repeat my sentence. Why we are going to, what is exactly a PDF file? PDF file is nothing but it is same like a folder in Windows where we are saving some files. So it is a collection of files that are stored in the folder. This folder is nothing but in mainframe called as PDF file. So here we are going to give the name for PDF file dot RAM dot pds and don't forget to close the single quotes. So the single quotes are mandatory, you can't miss single quotes. I'll tell you in next video what if we missed single quote, so how our name of the pds file look like, that will be seeing in next video. So and the naming convention of the PDF file is also same like PS file. Just to create the PDF file, just press A in option menu and press enter. So the parameters are same like PS file. Just we need to give the directory block in case of PDF file. You must have remembered that in PS file we are going to give 0 in directory block, because you can read here 0 for sequential data set, but in PDS we have to give some parameters for directory block, and this is the difference between the PS and PDS file. PS file having 0 directory blocks while PDS having some directory blocks, and the value of directory blocks is given to you if in your question paper, or if you are in project, then this value is given to you as per the requirement. For our case, we are just taking directory block as 2 for practice purpose, and we can take the record length and record size same, but these things also valid here. The block size must be multiple of record length, and to just create a PDF file, just press enter. And here we go, our data set is allocated. We have successfully created the PDF file. If you want to check the created PDF file, go to the primary menu. For that, you have to press F3 till your ISPF primary menu comes. So here we want to see the data set, the PDF created. So for that, just press print 3 and press enter. After that, press 4 print type 4 in option and press enter to see in data list. Enter and just type your mainframe ID dot asterisk to see all the file created by you, whether it is PS or PDS. You will get the list of each and every file created by you. So this is the file that we have created just now. If you want to open it, you can open it in edit mode. For that, you have to type E in front of it and you can enter, but as it is a PDF file, you can't enter it, because I told you na ke actually PDF file is like a folder, but we don't have any PS file inside a PDF file, PDF folder we don't have, so it will give gives us an error that no member contains or no member is in a PDS like that. So we'll check what error it will give. So for that, we have to press enter. After pressing enter, we will get a error popping here that no members in a data set, because there is no member in a data set. So how can he open the PDS file? For that purpose, we have to create one PS file and we have to store that PS file in a PDS file that we will see in next video. So for that, you have to like my channel, share my channel and subscribe my channel so that you will get my updates time to time. And don't worry, I'll upload my videos on daily basis so that you will get benefit of it and you will perform quite good in your training also. I know so many friends, they are having mainframe as their mainframe subject as in their training. So it is good thing to join my channel. So thanks for watching.